How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and for a lot of us, our computer just does not run as fast as we would like it to, or as fast as it did in the past, maybe. So in this video, we're going to go over 10 specific tips on some things you can try in Windows that may improve your computer's performance. Now, obviously, nothing beats a hardware upgrade, but if you do have a lower-end computer, some of these tricks might help. Now, if you have a high-end computer, a modern computer, you just upgraded or something and it's still running slow, you might have other issues that these probably won't help, but if your computer just over years has gotten slower or has always been kind of slow, these should help to some degree. So to start off, this one is probably only going to make a difference if you do have a very low-end computer or an old one or like an old laptop, and that is to turn off visual effects in Windows. Now, you can get to this by going to Start and then typing in Performance, and then go to the Adjust Appearance and Performance of Windows, and then check Adjust for Best Performance. And what this will simply do is remove a lot of like fancy animations, maybe graphical effects. So Windows will probably look a little bit uglier, but it may seem a little bit snappier because you're not like waiting for animations and stuff like that. So again, this will be for like very low-end hardware with very low graphics power. This could make a difference, but if you have a reasonably powered computer, it probably won't make a huge difference, so you may just prefer Windows to look nicer when you're using it and not choose this. Next up, for number two, this one will only actually apply if you have multiple operating systems installed. So if you don't, you can just ignore this one, but maybe listen to it if you're interested. So you may know when you dual boot a computer, usually it'll give you an option to select which operating system you want to boot to, and it'll spend a certain amount of time at that menu, and you can actually reduce that so it doesn't take like 30 seconds by default to boot up. And you can go to the settings to change this by going to Start and then typing in This PC, and then on that, click Properties on the right side, then go to Change Settings, Advanced, and then Startup and Recovery, and then go to Settings on there. And then look for the setting here called Time to Display List of Operating Systems, and you can change this from 30 second default to maybe something like 10, and that'll just save as much time as you shave off. But again, if you know you don't dual boot operating systems, it's probably better just not mess with those settings at all. The next thing you can try is to make Windows use a high performance power plan. You can get to this by going to the Start menu and then Settings, and then System, Power and Sleep, and then clicking Additional Power Options. And by default, this will show as balanced, but there will be other options likely showing up here, and high performance is obviously the one you may want to consider, especially if you're on a desktop. Now, if you're using a laptop that's always plugged in, you can also choose high performance, but just be aware, if you're using a laptop that is not plugged in, running off battery, then this will probably severely drain the battery life. So in that case, you might not want to change it, but if you are running off AC power, high performance is probably the best if your computer is noticeably slow most of the time. Also keep in mind though, this will make it so your CPU will run at a higher clock by default all the time. So if you're concerned about energy usage, or maybe you have really bad cooling in your computer, you may notice it running hotter and the fans running faster. So if you do notice that and you don't like it, you can of course just turn it off of high performance back onto balanced. But if you don't notice any issues at running at a higher heat, and it probably won't even be that big of a difference, you can just keep it on high performance. That's what I do on my main computer. The next thing you can try is either disabling or limiting Windows search indexing. So you can get to this setting by going to Settings, and then Search, and then Searching Windows tab. And you can either set this to Classic to greatly reduce the amount of files indexed. It will only be able to search within like libraries and the desktop, so it's not gonna search everything else on your computer. If you set it to Enhanced, I think that might be the default in newer installations of Windows. It's going to search other files beyond just the libraries. Now, this will probably make a bigger difference if you have a lot of files and you're running off a hard drive as opposed to an SSD. If you are using an SSD, it might not make that big of a difference, but it's still worth trying. But be aware, if you turn this off and then turn it back on, when Windows goes to re-index everything, it might slow down your computer for a little while it has to re-index everything. So just be aware of that, but you may notice a difference if you disable it completely on lower-end computers and you don't do a lot of searching for files. You kind of already know where everything is. It might be worth it to just turn it off so it's not chugging through files all the time. Now, the next feature we can take advantage of is called Ready Boost. You may have heard of it, but it allows you to insert a USB drive and kind of use that as extra slower RAM. So basically, Windows may use this to store commonly used files on the thumb drive, or I don't know, offload some RAM onto it if you don't have a lot of RAM. And the idea is, instead of using virtual memory on the hard drive, if you're using a hard drive that's very slow, if you use a USB drive because it's flash memory, that may be even faster. And that way you can get some potential extra speed if you are always running out of RAM and you have a slow drive. Now, to use this feature, you're gonna have to insert a thumb drive into any USB port on the computer, and I believe it should be between 1 gigabyte free and 32 gigabytes free. And there can, I believe, actually be files on it already. Windows will kind of separate out some data and reserve it. But in any case, after you put in the drive, you go to this PC where it lists all the drives inserted, you right click on the flash drive, and then hit properties, and then go to Ready Boost. If your computer's fast enough where it would not benefit from this at all, like on my computer, it'll tell you so, and it'll tell you it's not even worth it, don't even bother. But if you do have a computer that could potentially benefit from it, you'll have several options. So you can select either dedicate this device to Ready Boost, in which case I believe it may wipe it, or you may have to wipe it yourself first, or you can just hit use this device and then select an amount to reserve for this feature. Again, this feature will probably only make a difference if you do not have a lot of RAM in the first place. So either you have 4 gigabytes or potentially less, or you have less than 8 gigabytes, but you still use a lot of RAM, something like that, and your computer is constantly just running up against that limit and needs other places to store it, and your hard drive is not very fast for the page file, which we'll talk about next. So it might help if you have a very low-end computer, but if your computer is reasonably fast with RAM at least, then this might not benefit you, but it might still be worth trying. All right, now the next thing we can try is to increase the page file size in Windows. I'll try to explain how this works, kind of like the same idea with Ready Boost. Page file is a much older feature, and it's kind of the same thing, where if your computer starts to run out of memory, it will start storing temporary files or commonly used files that it still needs to access frequently in a so-called page file or a dedicated area of the hard drive instead of the RAM. It'll kind of, again, offload things from the RAM onto the hard drive and use that instead. But of course, a hard drive is many, many, many times slower than RAM, so it's kind of like a last resort. But if you don't have a lot of RAM, then you kind of still need to use this regardless. So what will happen is, if you don't have enough RAM and you don't have even enough page file size as a backup, then your computer will run extremely slow. So you want to make sure that your page file size is definitely big enough to use everything that it needs to. So to change these settings, what you need to do is go to Start menu. Again, we're going to do similar like before, type this PC, and then go to the properties there. Go to Advanced System Settings, the Advanced tab, under Performance, go to Settings, and then the Advanced tab here, and then look for Virtual Memory, and then click Change. By default, it will probably already say automatically managing paging file size for all drives. So if you do want to change this, you can just uncheck that. Then you're going to want to look for the drive labeled System Managed and just click on that. And this will show you some information about like how big the page file size is. And based on this, you may decide to change it or not. If the page file size is already about as big as your memory, your max RAM memory is, that's probably fine. But if it's very small, then you can change it. And you can do that by changing it to a custom size and then set the initial size to whatever is recommended, and then the maximum file size to really as much space as you're willing to afford. Or if you want to leave the system managed one alone, you can actually just add multiple drives if you have them and add an extra page file on an extra drive. So you can just click on a drive with no page file and then also select system managed size or select custom. So that way it'll still manage automatically the size of it. You'll just have an extra one in there. And ideally, if you have an SSD, you would put at least one of the page files on an SSD, because it's a lot faster than a hard drive and even faster than what you would get from a Ready Boost thumb drive. So ideally, a page file would be at least one of them on an SSD if you can afford it, but still having one that's the proper size, even on a hard drive, is better than nothing. All right, now the next two are kind of related, and it has to do with making sure there's no like corrupted files within the Windows installation. And the first one is the System File Checker. And this is a tool built into Windows that will automatically, like I just said, do a scan of the Windows files, check if there's any corruptions or anything, and try to repair it automatically. So to do this, you'll need to go to the command prompt. So you can just go into the Start menu, search command prompt or CMD, and then right click it, hit run as administrator, and it'll come up. and then you type in SFC space slash scan now, and then just let it do its thing. It might take a while, like an hour or more potentially, but you can do other stuff while it's running. And then hopefully it'll say that there's no errors found, but it might come back with something and then try to repair it. Hopefully it will successfully repair it in that case. Now, I can't get into all the errors it may produce if something goes wrong. You'll just have to Google that and try to fix it yourself. There's too many for me to even potentially cover. So at least if you run this and it does show something, you'll know something could potentially be wrong. Now, after you run the system file checker, there is yet another command you can type in, which kind of does a similar scan, but a little bit in a different way, but it'll also do the same thing essentially, where it'll scan for corrupted files, try to replace them with Windows Update automatically. So again, you're gonna wanna open the command prompt and then type in the following command. I'll put these in the description so you can just copy and paste them, but it's dism.exe space slash online space slash cleanup dash image space slash restore health. And again, you'll just run that, let it do its thing, and hopefully it will be able to repair any issues if it finds any at all. Now, one big thing to point out is after you run system file checker and then the DISM command, let them both run through, you probably want to restart and then run system file checker again. And this is because both of the commands to do the scans may rely on files that the other one may have repaired. So if the system file checker was unable to repair something, then when you ran the DISM, that might have actually fixed a file that will allow the system file checker to repair it the next time you run it. So that's why you want to run both and then run system file checker again, and then hopefully that will fix it if there is any lingering problems. And these are good commands to run every once in a while, even if your computer isn't having issues, because there might be some corrupted file that doesn't really make that big of a difference, but they start to add up over time, and then before you know it, you are having issues. So it's good to just kind of keep on top of these and run these scans to make it sure everything's always working well. All right, up next, we want to take advantage of Windows automated maintenance. Now, this is something Windows should run automatically really every day, but if it's not working correctly, then that could cause issues. So you can get to this by going to the Start menu and then typing in Control Panel and then going to System and Security, Security and Maintenance, and then go to the drop down next to Maintenance. Here you can check the last run date of the automated maintenance. So if it's been a while, you can go into the Change Maintenance Settings and select a better time where the computer may actually be on. I believe even if it's set to 2 a.m. by default, then it'll probably just run the next time Windows starts up. But that may not be happening if you notice that it hasn't run in a while. So just set it to a time where, you know, you might not be using the computer, but it's still on. Or you can also click Start Maintenance and it will just do it immediately. And this just does some things like runs defragmentation on your hard drive if it's required, that sort of thing, just to keep things up and up. All right, now if you have tried pretty much every single thing to get your computer running faster and it still has not, there is pretty much one last nuclear option, which is the feature called Reset This PC. And if you don't know how to reformat a hard drive, which would really be the best ideal scenario, but it is pretty complicated, resetting the PC is the next best thing. And this will basically restore Windows to its kind of default state. It'll, I believe, uninstall all programs, reset all settings, stuff like that. But I believe it should keep your files intact. It's supposed to, but of course you always want to back up before doing something like this. So your library files will still be there, but programs may not. So you may as well consider this a method to basically reinstall Windows and kind of start from scratch. Now, before I tell you how to do this, be sure to stick around the rest of the video because I am going to talk about some more obvious things that you should definitely do before even resorting to this, but I didn't want to mention them first because they're kind of obvious, but still you should try them before doing this. But if you do need to, here's what you do. You go to Settings and then Update and Security and then go to Recovery, and then you'll have the option to reset this PC, and I'll kind of walk you through it, tell it how it works. But again, do this as like a last resort. All right, now we're not done yet. Those were the 10 main things I wanted to mention in this video because they're not so obvious, but they will still probably help. But there are still some things you can try that may make a little bit of a difference, probably not, but maybe. And then at the end, we can talk about some stuff that really you should try probably first, but they are kind of obvious, so I didn't want to, you know, go through all of those at the beginning. So the first thing you can try is to disable Windows Tips and Tricks. So you can do that by going to Settings, System, notifications and actions, and then uncheck get tips, tricks, and suggestions. And supposedly this may help because it reduces the amount of Windows tracking what you're doing so it can provide tips for you. So I don't know, it may make a difference. The next thing you can do if you don't use Windows OneDrive is to stop that from starting up with Windows and syncing. So you can do that by right-clicking on the taskbar icon for OneDrive, and then go to Settings, Settings tab, and then uncheck where it says Start OneDrive Automatically. And then if you don't use this, then it's not gonna start up and start trying to sync and slow down your computer. It's just one less thing that starts up. Another thing you can try to at least get an idea of what may be causing your computer to be slow is to run a performance monitor report. And you can do this by going to the Start menu and just typing perfmon, P-E-R-F-M-O-N, /report. And this will then open up the performance monitor. Do a scan of what's going on in the computer for about 60 seconds, it'll tell you that, and then it'll print out a basic report. And this won't actually fix anything, but you may get some hints as to what's causing issues and slowdowns. So you can look at like any big warnings or under the basic system checks if there's any issues with the drives or something, it may tell you that, or check the resource overview for anything obvious. If you don't really know what you're looking at, this may not be very helpful, but if you are a little bit more tech savvy, then you can at least get an idea. Maybe if you see some big warning and you're like, oh, that's pretty obvious, I should fix that right now, it might be actionable. All right, now finally, we can go over some tips that should be pretty obvious, but these are things you really should try if your computer is running slow. These will probably make the biggest difference, but I'm kind of assuming most of you already tried these, but if you haven't, these are some things you need to do. First of all, if your hard drive is getting filled up, even if it's an SSD, you need to really free up as much space as you can. So go through the programs, list of programs under settings and then apps, and just uninstall anything you don't ever use. That's just taking up space. You can also use a program I really like called WinDirStat, and this will literally show you the biggest files on your computer. So if you see one that's like massive, that you're like, oh my gosh, I forgot this video file or something like that, then you can go in and delete it and it should be pretty obvious. The next thing, which I mean is pretty obvious, is disable as many startup programs that you're not using as possible. So if you're not gonna at least uninstall a program you don't use, at least have it not start up with Windows. And you can do this, it's really easy, by pressing Control Shift Escape to bring up the Task Manager. Now you can really easily go to the Task Manager Startup tab and it'll tell you everything that's starting up with Windows. And these days, it'll even try to tell you which programs have the highest startup impact and use up the most resources. This might not always be super accurate, but it'll still give you a pretty good idea. So just go through here. If you know you don't use a program, then you can just right click and have it not start up with Windows. If you're not sure what a program is at all, might not be the best to disable it, because then you might be disabling something that's kind of important. But if you recognize a program and you're like, oh, I never use that, then you can just stop it from starting up. And that should make a really big performance increase, because not only will it speed up the startup of your computer, but then it'll reduce the amount of things that are running in the background constantly, because usually if something starts up with Windows, it's never going away. All right, now the final tip I should mention is really good if your computer is running slow for like one time, one day, but not usually, and that is to actually go into the Start menu and hit Restart as opposed to shutting down and turning it back on. And the reason for that is that Windows 10 actually does by default kind of like a hybrid hibernate slash shutdown, where if you just shut down, it actually saves a lot of the stuff still running onto the drive, so it can retrieve that and then restore it into the RAM and boot up Windows faster. But that also means if there's some things running in the RAM that are causing the computer to slow down, then that will persist even after shutting down the computer. Whereas if you do a restart, Windows will completely clear it out and really start from scratch and actually do a restart. So if your computer is running slow and you're trying the old turn it off and on again thing, try just hitting the restart. It'll do a proper restart as opposed to shutting down, which might not. So those are hopefully a lot of tips to make your computer run faster, again, if it's been running slow. Now, if you want to keep watching, I did make a very similar video talking about some more tips, how to speed up your computer if it's running slow. I'll put that link right here on this side if you just want to click on that. So let me know what you guys think down in the comment section, especially if these helped, you can let me know down there. And thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.